The World Cup of Hockey is right around the corner.
Yeah, it is. And that's what everybody loves, is to get a chance to see the hockey again. It has been a summer of interesting moves, all kinds of things that go on in the offseason. But we're getting closer, and pretty soon we'll be talking about it. We'll be seeing it.
We had some news today. Group play, the schedule was announced today. The tournament, of course, starting mid-September, September 17th. Taking a look at Team USA and what their schedule looks like. Their first game against Europe coming up on the 17th at 3:30. The big one highlighted right there in yellow. Canada, USA, September 20th. Circle that one on your calendar.
Yeah, that'll be a good one. That'll be the test for both of these teams that both, and I think rightfully so, view themselves as the favorite. We look at Canada. I always think of Canada as a favorite to win all these tournaments. But Team USA, they have been a force as well. So it should be a lot of fun, and maybe we'll see them play later on in the tournament as well when we get into the chance to win it all.
It certainly is going to be a fun tournament. Some of the top players in the world on display in Toronto. Taking a look at Team Canada and their group play schedule coming up, as that was announced earlier today as well.
2002, I was at that one in Salt Lake when Canada beat Team USA.
They open up against the Czech Republic on the 17th. That's an 8 o'clock start time, East Coast. As we mentioned, they play the U.S. September 20th, and then round things out against Team Europe on the 21st. And maybe the most exciting team in this is Team North America, the Young Guns, as they're called right now. Look at these guys taking on Finland on the 18th at 8 o'clock, then Russia a day later, and then finishing out their three-game group play against the Swedes on September 21st. This team is certainly going to be must-watch TV because these guys are exciting.
Yeah, it's they're a wild card in all this. I think they have the talent to get it done. When you think about, first of all, McDavid, Eichel, and Matthews on the same roster, these young guys, I mean, that's incredible. They will not have an opportunity to play with each other all that often when you think about it. They're on different NHL teams. Of course, Eichel and Matthews, Americans, will play together down the road. They've already played under the red, white, and blue. But the chance to have these three all together playing on the same team, that is something unique. A lot of skill. We love McDavid. We love Eichel. We love Matthews. Very interesting for Matthews because he hasn't even played a game in the National Hockey League yet, and he's going to be part of this elite tournament. It reminds me of the circumstance with Eric Lindros back with the 1991 Canada Cup. Lindros had yet to play in the National Hockey League, and yet he was part of Team Canada in that tournament, beating out a pretty good fellow by the name of Steve Yzerman to earn a spot on that team. So they will be a wild card here, Team North America. We thought the area of weakness might be in goal,
yeah,
but they come in.
They have a Stanley Cup goalie.
A Stanley Cup goalie. Like, he's faced all kinds of adversity already, and he has been able to walk away with his name on the Stanley Cup. So this is something that's a really big development for this Team North America. There was a lot of talk about John Gibson, and he's great, so he'll be there as well. But I think you got to go forward with Matt Murray. He's won a Stanley Cup already, and even have Connor Hellebuck there, who could be someone helpful as well. So an area that we weren't sure of, all of a sudden, maybe an area of strength for Team North America.
How much pressure is on these young kids? Is there more pressure or less pressure playing for this team?
I think there's less pressure because they are not playing for their country. They are playing kind of for each other. It's a unique circumstance. They can be a little bit loose. Let's face it, the expectations, we think they're going to play well, right? And they're going to, in that room, they probably think, hey, we can compete with these guys. But generally speaking, people will say, well, these are the young guys. And if they lose, well, you know, that was expected, kind of. They were playing against these veterans, these grizzled veteran men players who've been playing in these kind of tournaments for a while. So I think expectations will be low. I think that will benefit them. It'll be interesting to see how Todd McClellan, who is the coach of the Edmonton Oilers, he's the coach of this team, if he lets them loose, lets them run a little bit. That's what I would do. If they have the right approach and they come together in that locker room, because it is unique. You have Canadians, you have Americans. If they can come together and the chemistry is there, I think they've got a great chance to maybe surprise a lot of people because there's a lot of talent in that room.
Can they win it?
I think they can.
Yeah.
I mean, again, the question is goaltending, right? You asked me 5 months ago, we don't even really know that much about Matt Murray. We're really counting on John Gibson a lot in this circumstance. Now you have two guys there, and even if you had to go to Hellebuck, he played a lot in Winnipeg this year. There's more experience in net now, and a guy who lifted the Stanley Cup in Matt Murray as your guy that can be your starter. Why not? I think they can win it.